In this video, I'm going to show you how to convert your old backyard swing set playscape into a chicken coop so you can raise your own chickens and get your own eggs and, best of all, not have to figure out how to get rid of your old swing set.
So I'm about to start a garden project where I'm going to turn this now unused playscape into a chicken coop.
I will confess that I didn't draw these plans up before I started this project, which would have been a much better idea. I drew them up afterwards just to show you what I ended up doing, but it would have made the whole process easier if I had drawn this up ahead of time and followed the plan.
The playscape used to be used by my two daughters, who have outgrown it and spend no time out here on it, and it's just sitting in the yard, taking up space, collecting junk underneath it. It seems like a pretty good structure. It's got a space underneath that can be used for a chicken run, and a space up above that can be used for the coop.
I got some black vinyl covered hardware cloth. It's 1 inch by 1/2 inch. That's small enough to keep out any predators. It's good, solid material, and it looks pretty good. It's definitely strong enough to keep the chickens in. Hopefully it'll keep everything out. What I'm worried most about is the hawks. I've had a couple hawks come in and sit on top of the swing set, licking their chops, looking at my chickens. But so far, no incidents with them when they're out of the run. I gotta try not to let them run around the yard when I'm not around, because there are hawks that swoop in, and that could be bad. I got a 4-foot by 50-foot roll, which was just about right for the job.
I'll have to cut that and put it in at the bottom. I'll need to build a ramp from the bottom run up to the top so that they can get up to their coop. I'll need to figure out where their roost is going to go in there, where their nesting boxes are going to go, and I'll need to work on access points to get eggs and also for cleaning and to let the chickens in and out.
So my swing set to chicken coop conversion checklist consists of 1, build the walls to enclose the coop, 2, add the access doors, 3, install the hardware cloth, 4, build and install the ramp, 5, figure out where it's going and build the roost, 6, figure out where the nesting box is going to go and build that. I'm also going to have to add asphalt shingles to reinforce the roof, and I'm going to have to add an additional roof over this outside deck area.
So I've got these windows that are extras, and I'm going to try and incorporate these into the coop, give the chicken some sunlight. I'm a little worried about the roof. It's seen better days, so I may have to add something to that to keep the water out. It's got vented mesh on the sides, which is probably not super secure. It's a pretty big area under here. It's about 10 feet across from there to there. Between these two 4x4s, it's about 4.5 feet, and then another 4.5 over here. Unfortunately, these angles are not quite the same, so I can't just run hardware cloth right along them. What I think I'm gonna have to do is run it along here, then cut in. There, and then follow this across and then down straight. So it'll be kind of a T shape with a long across the top and then a T coming down there. The nesting box is going to be along this end here. Hopefully have windows in some of these walls, and this wall will probably just be solid.
So the first thing I had to do was remove all the railings and all the hardware that kept the railings and extra pieces on that I was not going to use for the coop. Some of the wood on the deck area was kind of rotten, and it was where they were going to need access to their ramp to go downstairs anyway, so I'm going to pull that rotten wood out and replace it and leave the opening for them to go down and use the ramp. I bought 1 bundle of asphalt shingles for the roof, and it was just about right. It would have been better if I'd had a little bit more, but I stretched it out so I didn't have to go buy a whole nother pack and have a bunch left over. Next, I started building the wall panels, framing them out with 2x4s,
4 foot by 4 foot square made out of 2x4s that's been inserted in there. What I'm gonna do is make a wall out of that with plywood, and I'm gonna put a pivot hinge right. There's a hole through that 4x4, and the whole thing's gonna spin on that so I can open up the whole wall for easy clean out.
And then sheathing it with plywood. The coop is basically a square, and the two ends are 4x4 panels. It was the middle of July and it was starting to get hot here in southern New England.
So I've gone underneath and removed these braces so that I can cut through without hitting metal. So, I'm gonna take a break, it's hot as hell out here, and figure out what I'm doing, kind of making it up as I go, so. So, it's middle of October now. I've been done with this for maybe a month and a half. I kind of finished around Labor Day when the chickens came. A lot of time was spent putting the hardware cloth around the perimeter of the run on the bottom, you know, keeping them safe during the day when they're outside of their coop in the run. Just cut the hardware cloth at an angle. You can see on there. Had to make sure I got all these holes so that no critters can get in there. I had to kind of frame out the area that the door would go into for this coop. So I attached a couple of 4x4s to the framework of the Playscape that let me mount this old screen door. Finished up the roof, which was good, it needed it. Seems to be working pretty good, staying dry inside. I repurposed a lot of stuff that was on the playset. There's the sort of climbing chain ladder that works out good for a roost for them. They're sitting over there right now. I hung that underneath the playset. And I'm gonna show you how I let the chickens in and out every night. It's the kind of the front door of the coop. It's kind of cool. It's the whole wall. This is a repurposed screen door that a buddy of mine had lying around. And I used it for the door for the coop, works pretty good. Put hardware cloth on it, works great. Came with hinges and everything. and that's how they get in and out. They come over, they go down their little hatch there that's got a ramp connected to it where they can come down and can hang out on their roost. So you can see I kind of built a timber frame around the perimeter, and that I can attach this hardware cloth to. The hardware cloth is a 1-inch by 1/2-inch grid. I got 50 feet of it, which was just about perfect. I made a ramp at 2 2x4s. It goes up. Put the hardware cloth on all the walls on the bottom of the run. Up here, there's like where their balcony is. Put hardware cloth around the walls there too. Basically extended it around the whole perimeter of the playscape. On the top, to keep the water off this balcony area, I got this corrugated plastic. I got one sheet of it that was about 12 feet long and cut it into 3 pieces, which was just about right to cover it. It's kind of flimsy. It's not super, I don't know if you can see that, but it's pretty flimsy. Flimsier than I thought it would be. But it seems like it'll work just fine. Again, there's the hardware cloth. Cut it to fit all the shapes that I needed. Should keep anything out. They're not gonna be in that space during the overnight anyway, it's just during the day. At night, they'll go into the coop, which is much more well protected.
It got pretty cold and the water started to freeze in the coop, so put a light in at first, and I closed up the vents with some black plastic. Eventually I put a seed starting heating pad underneath their water, and that did a good job of keeping the water from freezing, and I took the light out. Finally in February they started laying eggs. Started out with this little tiny one, and then they started being regular, normal sized ones. So here's how the back door swings open when I need to clean it out. It makes it pretty easy to just scoop stuff out of there. The door for the nesting box is just a piece of plywood cut to size and attached with strap hinges. At the moment, it just stays shut by its own weight. For the time being, I just lean a big board up against it at night. I may decide to put a latch on that to make sure no critters like raccoons get in there. I put this ladder here so thinking that it would be easier for my kids to come out and pick up eggs, but they're kind of big enough, they don't really even need it. But it's just an idea of what you could do with the extra ladder if you have little kids who would need it to get up there. So they started out kind of slow, but now it's March, April, and we're getting about 18 or 20 eggs a week from the 3 hens. If we're around and out in the yard, I'll let the chickens out and they kind of free range around the yard and scratch around in the garden. So far they haven't destroyed too much of the garden, but I will keep an eye on that. They like to dig in the compost pile most of all. Lots of good stuff in there. So we got three hens. There's Mac, who's a Buff Orpington. She's the big one, and she's at the top of the pecking order. She steals everybody else's food and kind of bosses them around. Then there's Lucy, a Rhode Island Red. And then there's Skinny, who is supposed to be an Araucana, but is an Easter Egger hybrid. Overall, I'm pretty happy with this project. It's been fun. Fun for my kids, fun for me. Nice to have eggs. They're kind of cool to have running around the yard. And also, like I said, now I don't have to figure out how to get rid of this old Playscape, turn it into something useful. A friend of mine once called my garden ramshackle style, which is about right. So you could certainly add some paint and spruce yours up a little bit if you wanted to. So hope the video was helpful, and good luck if you decide to do something like this.